How did you get up?
I didn't care about boxing. I didn't care about living. I just wanted to die. And I was going to have a good time doing it while I was doing it. Shit.
We go to the scorecards. All three scores to the winner by unanimous decision. From the United Kingdom,
buhat ng maging Unified Heavyweight Champion noong 2015 nang talunin niya si Vladimir Klitschko by a unanimous decision, ay tila nalula siya sa kanyang nakakasilaw na tagumpay.
I wake up and I think, why did I wake up this morning? This is coming from a man who had everything, money, fame, glory, titles.
Sa kanyang ang kaliwat kanang selebrasyon, ay tila ba nawalan na ito ng motibasyon sa pagbuboksing. Hanggang sa tuluyan na nga itong nalulong sa alak at sa droga.
From drink, drugs, and his darkest moments.
Na naging dahilan upang mapabayaan niya rin ang kanyang pag-iensayo.
I didn't care about boxing. I didn't cup and I think, why did I wake up this morning?
Dahil nga sa kawalan ng disiplina sa kanyang sarili, ay tuluyan nang tumaas ang timbang nito at lumobo.
It's not like a fighter's body.
Amidst a life of unmitigated excess, he ballooned to almost 400 pounds.
He was in a bad way, and he was in a worse way than what we thought he was, because we didn't know what was going on.
Fury looked like a beaten man.
Dahilan upang hindi ito makalaban muli at para madepensahan ang kanyang mga titulo.
3-year timeline which saw the downfall of a heavyweight icon.
There you go. It's not like a fighter's body.
Kaya unti-unti ding inalis sa kanya ang kanyang mga title belt.
I've put everything in the gym for this and I just can't believe it and I've got it.
At dahil din sa paulit-ulit niyang pagbagsak sa kanyang mga drug testing, maging ang kanyang lisensya sa pagbuboxing ay tuluyan na ring sinuspindi.
Thoughtless behavior and a suspended license, reaching his own Mount Everest wasn't quite everything he had imagined.
Dahil nga dito ay tuluyan na siyang nagpakalango sa mga bisyo. Hanggang sa nawalan na rin siya ng ganang mabuhay.
I didn't care about boxing, I didn't care about living, I just wanted to die. And I was gonna have a good time doing it while I was doing it.
Same car, got the same watch.
Sinking into a downward spiral of drink and drug-fueled depression.
Ang kanya namang ama na dating professional boxer na naging inspirasyon niya rin upang pumasok sa mundo ng boxing ay tila wala ring nagawa para mapigilan siya.
Along with the best of them, isn't it, to be honest with you, because it is an intriguing story. Because 2 years ago, I thought he was finished. I thought he's down and out. All I wanted for him 2 years ago was some kind of normality. Never mind to the limits he's reached today. I thought we can just get him on a level keel so he can be a father to his kids, you know, and do something positive with his life. You know, but boxing and coming back to this level was a far cry. It was a dream that had been shattered. But here we are, under 2 years later.
Tanging ang kanyang kalugar na taga Manchester din at dati niyang idolo na si Ricky Hatton ang gumabay at umalalay sa kanya.
As the city's most popular pugilists,
I wouldn't have sent him out with them tactics. I was telling all my mates, oh, he don't want to be doing that, he don't want to be doing that. And he's done it. Made me look a right idiot, to be fair, but good on you, Tyson.
Hatton helped drag Fury off the canvas and has been in his corner throughout his recovery from drink, drugs, and his darkest moments.
Bukod tanging si Ricky Hatton lang ang nakapaghikayat sa kanya na magbago at bumalik sa boxing ring.
At the time, nobody realized quite how serious he was. The tortuous route to redemption was on. And at first, taken with a pinch of salt, gaining little attention.
It was a mammoth task. It was mission impossible, to be honest with you, at first. Everybody thought he was finished.
Matyagaan niya tong sinasamahan araw-araw upang mag-training.
Set the comeback alight. Free to fight again after the backdated 2-year ban, 2018 was marked as the year Fury would return.
Matatandaan na pagkatapos talunin at pabagsakin ni Manny Pacquiao si Ricky Hatton.
Oh my gosh, what a straight left hand. And
will Hatton make it up from this?
Can he beat the count?
Is that it? And Kenny Miller says, no way. That is that. What an amazing knockout shot.
Naabot din na matinding depresyon si Hatton. Nalulong din ito sa alak at sa droga.
You know, to keep you drinking more, then obviously I started, you know, taking drugs, you know.
At minsan na rin nakaisip na tapusin ang kanyang buhay.
I've got no mom and dad. I've got no boxing no more. What's my point being here on planet Earth?
Kaya bukod tanging si Hatton lang ang nakakaintindi sa kanya. Dahil siya ang masigit na nakakaalam kung ano ang pakiramdam ng pinagdadaanan niya.
Talks quite openly about going through depression, as you have. So you're in a very good position to explain to us how tough it would have been for him.
He's leaving a legacy like that big now, isn't he? You know, with what his many have been on the journey that Tyson Fury.
Kaya ganun na lang din ang tuwa nito nang nakabalik si Tyson sa dapat niyang kalagyan na maging champion muli.
Telling all my mates, oh, he don't want to be doing that, he don't want to be doing that. And he's done it. Made me look a right idiot, to be fair, but good on you, Tyson. Achieved, you know, when you look at the heavyweights through history, not many have been on the journey that Tyson Fury's been on.
Ganun din ang kanyang ama. Sa labis na tuwa at sobrang pagka-proud nito, ay halos ayaw niya na raw magising kung sakaling nananaginip lang siya.
Tyson's father, John Fury. John, you must be the proudest dad in the world today.
I'm so. I'm the proudest man ever. I couldn't be no happier. I said a few weeks ago on an interview, I'm on an Indian summer, and I think that's an understatement as well. I can't explain how I feel, you know, it's just, I'm frightened to go to sleep in case I wake up and it was a dream or something, you know, so, yeah, good things are happening, and I can't express how I feel to the public who made them flights over there, all that way to Vegas to support my son. Thank you to every single one of them.
And that's been on the agenda at Manchester Council today, a parade to put him on the same pedestal as the city's most popular pugilists.
I wouldn't have sent him out with them tactics. Every time he opened his mouth, he said something wrong, didn't he? Because he was in such a bad place. Do you know what I mean? He insulted practically anybody who moved because he was in such a bad place. But because he's got his boxing together and he's right mentally upstairs, I think his fan base has grown.
I think he's inspiring other kids to do boxing as well as he's doing it.
At sa ngayon, bukod sa pagte-train sa kanyang anak, siya din ang nagte-train sa kapatid ni Tyson Fury.
Much like other professional sports, is a game of extreme highs and intense lows.
This is boxing at its best.
Where fighters push themselves to the very brink, where results hang on a knife edge, and where every step is scrutinized.
You never give me a fair shake. HBO needs to fire you. You don't know shit about boxing.
And whilst every young star has a target or milestone he or she pursues, there is no preparation or guidebook on how to control your emotions once achieving your wildest dreams. Something which, on that night in Dusseldorf, became a fighting man's reality. A 3-year timeline which saw the downfall of a heavyweight icon.
There you go. It's not like a fighter's body.
This was a Rocky movie happening in front of my very eyes. And my first question to you, Tyson, how did you get up?
Dragged back from the edge by his wife and children, it was only at his very lowest that something clicked into place.
Think about your family and your little boys and girls growing up with no father. And I thought, that day, I'll never, ever, ever try or think about taking my own life ever again.
I promise to you and to BT Sports and to the world of boxing is, I will reign supreme once again.
The homecoming echoed the champion's former vibrance.
It's quite inspirational, isn't it? Silenced all them Americans.
And I was going to have a good time doing it while I was doing it.
Though a timeline which, through faith and credence, represents one man's hope.
I think this is my calling card fight.
And a nation's endearment. From villain to hero. From dark to the light. From outcast to king.
Bigger and better things from now on.
Expect
to see a new heavyweight champion.
Last tape in the air! I'll fight now! Yep. So hard for this! You know, it's been 6 months and I've put everything in the gym for this and I just can't believe it that I've got it.
Neutral corner and now Fury's looking to split the guard as Wilder's in bad shape. This the fight is over!
A memorable fight, Tyson Fury.
To take a hell of a fighter to stop this guy.
Showed the world tonight, everyone suffering with mental health, that you can come back and it can be done.
Our journey back to the top is called Road to Redemption.